Hello, my name is Bob Knight. I'm a professor of psychology and neuroscience at the University of California, Berkeley, and a recipient of the 2024 Distinguished Scientific Contribution Award from the APA. I'm here because of serendipity in my career. I was a physics major and advice from my favorite physics professor. She told me to go to med school. I went to med school. I really liked my neurology rotation. I was very excited by the spectrum of problems you saw from brain damage and the behavioral disturbances. Went on to neurology residency. During neurology residency, I was again very fortunate to be engaged with Steve Hilliard and Bob Galambos, early leaders in human electrophysiology. And I learned a lot of techniques from them. I did a postdoc with another brilliant human neuroscientist, Helen Neville, and then went on to my first faculty job at Davis. I had read a book during my neurology rotation as a med student called The Working Brain by A.R. Luria, where this brilliant neuropsychologist studied brain lesions to make inferences about organized behavior and the role of the frontal lobe in many, many behaviors. I decided to fuse brain lesions and electrophysiology that I got from Hilliard, Neville, and Galambos. And for the next several years, did a lot of studies looking at using these methods to understand attention, decision-making, memory, and the like. I moved then from the neurology department at Davis to the psychology department at Berkeley in 2000. And there was another change in my research focus because it became widely accessible to be able to study patients who had implanted electrodes for evaluation of intractable epilepsy. This opened up a wonderful new signal space, including high frequency activity and even single unit recording in humans. The electrodes give you access to multiple brain regions that are involved in cognitive control, lateral frontal, orbital frontal, medial frontal, cingulate, hippocampus, amygdala. This approach employed to study a variety of behaviors over the years, many centered on the role of cognitive control and decision-making and attention. And it allows you to do two things. It allows you to both look at a region's contribution to the behavior of interest and to look at the network of brain regions. How do they interact? How does information flow between regions in the support of organized behavior and particularly in support of the role of the prefrontal cortex as the orchestrator of many of our most fundamental human behaviors. I think the future is very bright for the psychology of the mind with all these wonderful techniques available to the new waves of young investigators. I particularly want to thank my initial mentors and then my subsequent colleagues and the wonderful grad students and postdocs who actually have enabled this work. So thank you very much for your attention. And if you'd like to contact me, you can just go to my website and you can find my contact information. Again, thank you very much.